In the previous video, we started section and midpoint formula. Okay, so these were the two formulas. Basically, section formula means that there are two points, let's say 2,3 and 4,5, and they're divided by a point P, which is x, y, and the ratio is given as 4:5. So if I want to find the coordinates of this point P, which divides the line AB in the ratio 4:5, then to find x, I have the formula m1x2 plus m2x1 upon m1 plus m2, or it can be mx2 plus nx1, m or n or m1 m2, doesn't mean. Okay, this was for Frank textbook. Okay, this formula for y is also same, just in the place of x you put y, m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, point is on the x-axis. If whenever they give you x-axis, it's divided by x-axis, so you take the point of division as x, 0, and whenever they say y-axis, you take 0, y, and origin is 0, 0. I'll advise you to revise the first 5 sums which we did in the last class. Revise them, just flip your pages, just go through the sums and recollect the concept which I had taught, and then proceed with the video. Okay, for clear understanding. See, revision is the key, because whenever you do a new topic, you tend to forget. So I advise you again to revise those 5 sums, first 5 sums which we did, and then continue with the video. Okay, so today we'll do question number 6. Okay, so the question is, in what ratio, okay, the join of, there are two points given. Let's say the first point is A, second point is B, and their coordinates are 4,3, 2, -6. I have sent all the pics of this chapter from Frank as well as Concise in the group. Okay, this is from Concise, exercise 13A, question number 6. Okay, so they have given, in what ratio is the join of line 4,3 and 2,-6 is divided by x-axis. Okay, divided by x-axis means this point which is in between. Let's say the point is P. They have given x-axis, so this point will be x, 0. Okay, this point will be x, 0. Now, in what ratio means the first part which you have to find is the ratio. Second, they have said something else. They have said also find the coordinates of point of intersection. But they have said to find the coordinates of point of intersection. I'll tell you what it is. First, we'll find the ratio. So, in the fourth sum, in the fifth sum, third, second, third, fourth, fifth, in all the sums, we had found the ratio. Okay. So, whenever, if I want to find the ratio is like this, m1, m2. Okay. If I want to find the ratio, I have two choices here to use the formula of x or y. Okay, but the value of x is not known to me. I don't know the value of x. So I'll start with the value of y, because y is 0 here. So I'll use the formula of y. What was the formula? Make a habit of writing down the formula. Formula is y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. This was the formula. Now, here, let's substitute the values. I had told you the first point is x1, y1. The second point is
x2, y2.
And this point and center are x and
y.
Let's substitute the values. m1 is not known. y2 is -6 plus m2 is not known. And y1 is 3 upon m1 plus m2. And the value of y.
Value of y is from here. See, this value is nothing but the point of intersection. So this is y is
0. I'll put here
0. Now when this m1, m2 and go and multiply with this 0. For simplification, I'll multiply this m1, m2 into 0. I'll get 0 only. Anything into 0 is 0.
m1 into minus 6 is minus 6 m1. Plus 3 into m2.
Is 3 m2. Okay.
Let's shift this minus 6 m1 here. It will become plus 6 m1. Is equals to
3m2. Now this 6 will go down here and this m2 will come down
because I want the ratio of m1
upon m2. So
3 upon this 6 will come down.
6. See, this m2 came down, become m1 upon m2. This 6 came down, become 3 upon 6.
So this will become 1 upon 2. So my ratio m1 is to m2 is 1 is to 2.
First part of the sum is done.
Okay, this sum will come for 4 marks at least, 3 to 4 marks. Okay, if they are asking you 2 parts, then definitely they'll give it for 4 marks. Second part is find the coordinates
means x and y,
of the point of intersection. Point of intersection means basically this point, which point divides the line in some ratio.
Okay,
so point of intersection means this point, and they have said find the coordinates of this point. So for this point, I already know y is 0, but I don't know the value of x. Okay,
now I'll find the value of x,
because they have said also find the
coordinates.
So this coordinates I need to find, out of which y I already know is 0.
X I'm fine. X is m1 into x2 plus m2 into x1 upon m1 plus m2.
So m1, m2, now I know the value, 1 is to 2.
So I'll substitute in the place of m1, it will be 1
into
x2 is here 2 plus m2 is 2 into x1 is here 4 upon m1 plus m2 will be 1 plus 2. Value of x is
not known.
So let's simplify this. I'm sorry, here m2 is 2. You know the value of m2. Okay, so 1 into 2 is 2 plus 2 into 4 is 8 upon 3. 1 plus 2 is 3. Now 2 plus 8 is 10 upon 3. This is the value of x. I'll check the answer. This is exercise. We are doing exercise 13a, question number 6.
So here they had asked us to find out the coordinates of point of intersection. That means they asked us to find out the value of p.
So in the final answer you will write p is,
the value of x is 10 upon 3.
10 upon 3. You can even write the answer in mixed fraction,
comma,
value of y was already 0 because the point was on x-axis.
So this is 0. This is my final answer.
Okay.
This is how you have to solve the sum. First, we found the ratio.
Okay.
And then we did the solving and found the coordinates of point of intersection.
Okay.
Now, seventh sum, I want to do it on your own. You must do it on your own. Okay, I'll just draw the diagram for you. You should solve it. It is exactly same like the sixth one.
Okay, but still I'll draw the diagram for you. They have said in what ratio is the line. There is a line, a join. Line and join is same. Join is minus 4, 7 and 3, 0.
Okay.
Let's say the point of intersection is P. Is divided by the y-axis. They have said y-axis.
Y-axis means the point will be 0, y.
So the point will be
0, y.
Okay, ratio we don't know. Again, you have to find those two things only. The first thing you have to find is the ratio. And second thing you have to find is the coordinates of P,
which is called as the point of intersection.
So here, see, the value of y is not known to you.
But you know the value of x here is 0.
So you will start with the formula of x.
And you will solve the sum.
Okay. I hope you will be able to do it.
You can even pause the sum. Pause the video right now and solve the sum and check your answer.
Okay.
Question number 8.
8 is an important question, an interesting one. See, points A, B, C, D divide the line segment.
See, there are 4 points A, B, C, D.
Divide the line segment joining the point 5,
comma, minus 10.
See, there is a line segment
joining the points
5, comma, minus 10 and the origin. So, this point and this point. This point is 5 comma minus 10 and this point they have said is origin. Origin means 0 comma 0.
Okay.
So again I'll repeat the question. Points A, B, C, D.
Where are those A, B, C, D points? I'll mark here.
Wait. Divide the line segment joining the points 5 comma minus 10 and the origin in 5 equal parts. See, this line is divided in 5 equal parts. See, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Always remember, if you want to make 5 parts, you require 4 points. If you want to make 3 parts, you require 2 points. One less always.
So, I want to divide this line into 5 parts. See, 1, 2, 3, 4,
5 parts.
And what were the names of the points? Points A, B, C, D.
Divide this line segment into 4 parts.
Sorry, 5 parts. So, these are my points A, B, C, and D.
Okay,
equal parts. All these parts are equal. Okay, you understand equal?
Like this. So these are my 4 points A, B, C, D, which divide this entire line segments into 5 equal parts.
Okay, let's name these points also as P and Q.
Okay.
Now, what are they expecting us to do? They have asked us to find out the coordinates of B and D. What is to be found? B
and D, coordinates of B and D. One by one we'll have to find out.
Okay. I hope you have understood the question at least. How we'll do it is a different issue. We'll solve it step by step.
But understanding the question is also very important because you have to draw this diagram in exam on your own.
Okay. Now see. If I want to find the first the coordinates of B. Forget D now. Forget C. Forget A. Only B.
I have to find the coordinates B.
I'll label these coordinates as x and y.
Okay.
This coordinates x1, this is x, y1,
x2 and y2.
Now, is the ratio given in the question?
The ratio is not given directly in the question, but the ratio is given.
How? See, these are 5 equal parts.
Okay, you understand 5 equal parts? 5 equal parts means
all the values are same.
If this is 1, this is also 1, this is also 1, this is also 1 and this is also 1 because there are 5 equal parts.
So, if I see the ratio, see, if I keep my hand here on point B, there are 1 and 1,
2 parts here
and there are 1, 2 and 3.
3 parts on this side from point B as a reference. There are 2 parts here and there are 1, 2 and 3 parts here. So, basically point B has divided this line in the ratio 2:3.
I hope you understood. See, this point P
has broken this line into 3 parts and 2 parts. Means the ratio is 2:3.
Okay. So, for point B, 2:3 is the ratio. 2:3 is the ratio means M1, M2. Value of M1 and M2 is 2 and 3. Let's solve now. For x, x is equals to, the formula is m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. I substitute the values of x for x. So this is x, this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2. M1 is 2 into x2 is 0 plus m2 is 3, x1 is 5 upon m1 plus m2
means 2 plus 3. You solve it slowly at your pace, okay? If you are not able to catch my pace, you pause the video, substitute the values. See, this is the easier part, substituting values. You can do it on your own. Okay,
this equals to 2 into 0 is 0 plus 3 5 is 15 upon
5.
So this will become 15 upon 5, which is
3. So I got the value of x as 3. Now let's find y.
The value of y is not known. The value of m1 and m2 was 2 is to 3. And y1, y2, I'll see it from here. So
y1 is minus 10 and y2 is 0.
y1 is minus 10. m1 is 2. y2 is 0. m2 is 3. y1 is minus 10 upon 2 plus 3. Okay. So if you solve it further, 2 into 0 is 0, 3 into minus 10 is minus 30 upon 2 plus 3 is 5. So minus 30 upon 5 will give me
minus 6. This 0 doesn't have any value,
so I'll get minus 6. Now I've found the coordinates of point B for now. Okay, the coordinates for point B are, see, I'll write the answer here. Coordinates of point B, x I found as 3 and y I found as minus 6. So this part is done. B is done. Now let's find D. They had asked us to find out only B and D, not all the coordinates. So for D, now you forget this B part because B is gone. We have solved it. Now let's focus on D. I have to find D. Let's take x comma y as the value of D here. Okay, now what will be the ratio for D? Observe carefully the diagram. See, the endpoints are the same. The line is PQ. So the x1, y1 and x2, y2 will remain same. These are x1, y1, x2, y2. This is the point reference D. Now there is one part on the right hand side and 1, 2, 3, 4 part on the left hand side. So basically this point D is dividing the line into 4 parts on the left hand side, 1 part on the right hand side. So the ratio in which D is dividing the line is 4 is to 1. Okay, 4 parts here, 1 part here. So 4 is to 1. So I'll write here. For point D, ratio is 4 is to 1. That means 4 is m1
and 1 is m2.
Okay, again let's find the values of x
and y.
X is, formula is m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2.
I've told you the value of x1 and y1 will remain same, x1 y1 x2 y2, because they are endpoints.
Here I'll write the formula for this.
M2.
So see, solve it on your own, pause the video, solve it on your own and then check your answer. Simple calculation. See, more and more you solve it on your own, you'll find some mistakes here and there, you'll get confused, you'll get stuck, so your doubts will get cleared.
Okay,
so m1 was 4, x2, I'll see the value of x2. X2 is 0 and x1 is 5. X2 is 0 and x1 is 5 upon 4 plus 1, y is equals to 4 into 0 plus y1 was minus 10, 1 into minus 10 upon 4 plus 1. So 0 plus 5 upon 5, 0 plus minus 10 upon 5. 5 upon 5 is 1, minus 10 upon 5 is minus 2. So the point D is 1 comma
minus 2. Okay. That's it. The next time I'll do it in the next video.